Hello and welcome to IIFL Securities YouTube channel. I'm Shweta Papriwal. And as we know, the IPO Fino Payments Bank will be open for subscription from October 29th. So to get all the details about the company and IPO today, we have Mr. Ketan Merchant, CFO Fino Payments Bank. So welcome, Mr. Merchant. It's a pleasure to host you today.
My pleasure, Shweta. My pleasure.
So, sir, to start with the broad-based question, I would request you to brief us about the company and its business and its operations.
Yeah, Shweta, in simple words, Fino is a fast-growing and profitable fintech, a unique proposition, fast-growing fintech and profitable. What do? We have revolutionized banking requirements for people in tier 3, tier 4, and rural areas as well. The principal words which we work on is DTP, Distribution Technology and Partnership.
Okay.
I'll just elaborate in very what do we mean by that? We have more than 750,000 points through which we are all across India, through which we provide banking services. Mm-hmm. The largest point is what we are looking at in terms of distribution. So how does it work? In simple terms, your neighborhood mom and shop, kirane ki dukan, chemist ki dukan, becomes banker. Our philosophy is, for India to be bankable, completely bankable, we will make people of India as bankers. So, humne kirane ke shopar dukan wale ko ek banker bana diya. That's how we operate it off. He earns, we earn. Whatever transaction happens, he earns, and we earn both. That's how the distribution works. Technology is something which our Fino started off. In 2006-07, we started off as a technology company. So, we have a technology DNA into us. Everything which we do is through technology. One simple example, Shweta, I'll give you is, this is a micro ATM.
Okay.
This has a card slot.
Okay.
In simple terms, this is what, this does the function of traditional ATM. One can do cash withdrawal from any bank debit card from this. How does it work? There's a card slot out here. This is all connected through the back-end system. And the merchant or the distribution point or the banker, Babu, will end up giving cash. All of this with no incremental cost for any card holder.
Oh, that's lovely.
Is how we revolutionize. Yes.
Shweta.
To give a perspective, this machine cost INR 4,000.
That's it.
Okay. Yes. And this is doing the function largely for INR 550K machine, which is an ATM machine, which is that cost. So that's how we revolutionize. Just one of the examples of technology. Third is partnership. We work on partnership model. We operate through 11,000 BPCL petrol pumps. This is in semi-urban and rural areas. Mm-hmm. Our philosophy is whatever can be done through partnership, we need not reinvent the wheel. It is a cohesive approach wherein the partner earns, we earn, and that's how it is. Simple thing is, we want to provide financial services, whether it's cash deposits, cash withdrawal, remittance, payments, digital payments, for our target segment in a very simplistic manner. What is our target segment? We look at the middle end of the pyramid. For middle India pyramid, which is 60, 70 crores people which come in that middle class pyramid. And that's where we are focusing on. How do we do it? I explained technology, distribution points, and partnership. We work on an assisted digital model wherein we help customer into a journey of digitalization.
Right.
So
you've explained it very well. So, and a layman would also understand. So if you could also brief us about the IPO details and how is the company in fact planning to use the proceeds which they gather through the IPO?
Yeah, Shweta, so the IPO detail, it is getting launched on 29th October. It will go up to 2nd November. We are raising, the contours of the deal are, we are raising, somewhere around 1,200 crore on the upper end, of which it is divided into 300 crores as primary issuance and 900 crores as secondary. The utilization of primary funds is largely into two facets. One is technology and digital. We are ahead of the curve in terms of technology, and we want to continue to be ahead in terms of the times where we are in terms of growth. Just to give a perspective, in FY21, we process 1,30,000 crores rupees of transaction on our platform.
Mm-hmm.
Ours is a transaction platform. The utilization, we will further build our systems. We will have API things coming up. Open banking is what we are giving and strengthening system. We intend to have a digital overlay in all the products. So 75% of the new proceeds are going to be utilized in technology and digital. We also are going to utilize a bit of it in branding and marketing, you know, in times to come as well. So this is a broad gamut of our utilization of primary proceeds.
So to give our viewers a perspective, I would like to mention that IIFL Securities has a subscribe recommendation on Fino Payments Bank's IPO. So you can apply with IIFL Securities, you can subscribe with our IIFL Markets app. So the IPO is opening on October 29th. So please apply with IIFL Securities app. So now, as we know that you don't have, you know, quite a few listed players in the segment. So according to you, what is the outlook on this industry and what kind of changes have you noticed in the consumer behavior during the pandemic and post the pandemic, which it's going to, you know, unveil?
Yeah, I think it's a very pertinent question, Shweta. You know, I'll just take the pandemic question first.
Sure.
Pandemic has changed the thinking process of world at a large. You know, or everything we've challenged ourselves, or, you know, that how things can be different. It has changed the consumer behavior. Consumer right. behavior has had acceptance in terms of alternate banking channel. So instead of traveling for 5 kilometers, 4 kilometers, or 7 kilometers for finding an ATM or this thing, or for that matter, a bank branch, people are preferring if I can have my same services at my neighborhood shop. You know, mera jo dost hai, jo kirana ka shop chala raha hai, us pe without any additional charge, if I can have that, if I can have the same suvidha, why do I not go it up?
Right.
Pandemic year, I'll just give you some statistics. Well, the world was reeling. We grew by 41%. Our throughput increased in the 2021 pandemic year by 41%.
Correct.
That itself is a testimony that there is acceptance in terms of the model. On the top of that, for us, it is all about innovation. We focus on our target segment. We made an ecosystem through which we do transaction, and we keep on innovating. I just showed you a micro ATM, which is our innovation. The second is subscription-based accounts. You know, in financial services, we have pioneered subscription liability product. Our CASA is subscription. You just pay one-time fee in the beginning of the year. Thereafter, there are no transaction charges, no sort of cost coming into. There has been good acceptance on that as well. We have a renewal rate of 65% and plus in our subscription-based CASA account in our own time. So overall, pandemic is taught us a lot of things. Some of it we'll have to carry it forward. It is opened a thought process in terms of how people can think in an innovative manner for right services and stuff.
In fact, across industries, it has brought about a huge change.
Yes.
So, as you already mentioned that, you know, you've turned profitable in a pandemic year. So, if you could also brief us about the company's financial track record.
Absolutely. Just to give a perspective, we had processed transaction rupees 1,30,000 crore over last 2 years, which was 71% compounded annual growth from 19 to 21, 71% growth. In terms of revenue, our revenue is at 791 crores, which is a 46% growth from, you know, on an annualized basis, compounded CAGR growth for last 2 years. In a pandemic year, we grew by 41% in terms of our throughput, as I mentioned earlier. Profitability, our profitability journey started in Jan-March 20, which is, you know, last quarter FY20. Yes. Since then, it has been 7 consecutive quarters of profitability and growth.
Right.
Just to be one more perspective, COVID or non-COVID, you know, we've become relatively agnostic. Whilst we've had a strategic shift in terms of people's mindset, which is positive. Yeah. This year, quarter one over, you know, quarter one last year, our revenue grew by 36%. Profitability has increased by 69%, and throughput has increased, which is where our benchmark is. It's not a bank. It's a transaction platform with a regulatory enablement, and our throughput has increased by around 51% quarter on quarter. This quarter versus last quarter, same year.
So I believe
we are generating an ROE of 15% for full year FY21.
Right. So I believe you are going to continue with this growth trajectory going ahead.
Well, I would not want to comment on that, but I can just tell you that as per the CRISIL report, this industry, the digital payment industry, is expected to grow by 25% CAGR.
Right.
On a 25% growth on an annualized basis, year on year. We are in a sweet spot with the kind of ecosystem which we have, and we are looking at growth in line with industry and more.
Correct. Wish you all the best for that.
Thank you, Shweta.
So, sir, what is your outlook for the company? You've already given us a lot of information about that. However, I would like to understand the key growth strategies that you would be implementing going ahead.
Yeah, for us, everything revolves around these three pillars, which I have said, DTP. Okay, so I mentioned about technology and digital. We are investing into that. We want to be ahead of the curve. Distribution-wise, just to give a perspective, last year, every day in the financial year 21, we opened 1,000 new distribution points, or the merchant point, as we say. This year, first quarter, we on an everyday basis, we have increased it to 1,100. So that's the kind of expansion which we are looking at. For us, our market is really, really huge. The 70 right. crore population which we are looking at. So, it is our strategy is going to be wide and deep. Provide everything possible for our target segment. We have created an ecosystem. We have a platform. We want to be a gully fino. For anyone who wants to do financial services, he should feel as comfortable as he feels for, going out and getting grocery shop. Maybe in times to come, we would want to be at 100-meter or a 200-meter, kind of an outlet where you can see a fino outlet facilitating. Here again, it is about, partnering with the merchants and the distributor, which we are saying it. So that is how it is. Two things which we'll always do and is we will always be asset light. As I mentioned, right. currently, when we are expanding it off, we do not incur any capital cost. It is, we do not pay capital cost. It is the merchant who works it along with his shop. So we don't pay any capital cost. That's how we'll continue. Asset light model. And we will always have a variabilized cost model. Just to give a perspective, we do not believe in fixed cost. We will 71% of our cost is variabilized, which means we only pay when the transaction happens, when we earn. So these are the two aspects which we'll do. New products, which we are also adding in terms of our existing products, are we are providing credit referral. We are entering into a merchant loan space, consumer loan space, wherein we will facilitate a credit for them through our NBFC partners. We are also looking at international remittance. We are also looking at investment products. And we will do everything possible which caters to our target segment. That's what our endeavor is.
Right. So the expansion would be pan-India, right? In tier two, tier three cities, villages.
Absolutely. As we speak, 70% of our business essentially comes from the emerging India or the rural / semi-urban.
So thank you so much, Mr. Merchant, for giving us the perspective about the company, and we wish you all the best for the upcoming IPO. I would again ask my viewers to subscribe to this IPO, as we have a subscribe view on the IPO, and please subscribe to the IPO with IIFL Securities, IIFL Markets app. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Shweta. My pleasure. Have a good evening.